promise I won't fart anymore.
That would be really cool if you would refrain.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Uncle Michael. The one and only. My mentor. That's right, you're my mentor now, by the way.
Well, it's better than being a mentor, I guess.
That's true. You know you're the first one to be in one of my videos officially?
Is that right?
Yeah.
So, when they make millions of dollars, am I going to get a cut?
Yeah. That should be in, like, 2025.
Yeah. I don't think I'm going to see that. This guy's actually doing it right, as compared to the last fellow we witnessed, who...
Sorry about the bugs on the windshield, people, but, I got nothing.
Due to the fact... Now, see, he's got himself in a bind. You saw that jumping up and down like that?
Yeah.
As he's backing him. He's got it in a bind, and that's not a good thing. He's got setup issues as well, but not nearly as bad as that other truck did.
That guy with the lights on right there.
Yeah, he had issues from the word go because he kept setting up improperly.
Well, this guy's cocked pretty hard.
He's cocked pretty hard, but he's got a good view of the other side, and he's clearing this side by quite a bit. Being dark in here, though, it would be best if he were to get out and take a good look.
What do they call that, Mike? Getting out and... What's it get? Gut?
Goal.
That's right.
Get out and look.
Get out and look.
Should be goals. Get out and look, stupid. Or G-O-A-L-L, get out and look, lazy.
What other acronyms can we come up with?
Well, lots. But this fellow's actually doing a good job. He's doing it nice and slow. The only thing that I would say is because he got it in such a bind, that's why he's doing that hop, and it's hard on equipment, but he's doing it nice and slow. He's not getting in any kind of hurry. He's got a good view of the other side, and he knows, obviously, he knows what he's doing. He knows that he's cleared on the other side, so he should be in good shape on this side. And he also knows when to stop and to pull up, to unbind it. And see, now he's...
Well done.
He's certainly showing that Buell driver how it's done.
I wish I could back like that.
You can back like that.
Yeah, on a good day. When I don't look back there and I have a 70-foot trailer. You ever get those days? You look back there and you have like 600 feet of trailer. Some days you look back there and it's a little pup.
I have days when I couldn't hit a barn from the inside with a trailer.
There you have it.
And many of hundreds and thousands of times that I've backed up over the years, there are days when I just simply can't do it well. It's just, for whatever reason, and all drivers over their careers experience that. It's just the nature of the business. You're not going to do a great job of backing every time. So that's why you need to get out and look.
You heard it here first from Uncle Michael. Get out and look, lazy. Or get out and look, stupid. And look what he's doing now. He's getting out to look.
He's going to see how far he's got between him and the trailer behind him. But I think he was smart. And if you're doing this at night and you have a well-lit parking lot, you can see the light between the trailers where it hits the ground. So you can see the shadows of the trailers. You can get to within a reasonable distance, depending on where the light is. Then you get out and look and see how much you have to deal with. Now, I can see I would venture to say he's probably a foot to possibly 2 feet from the truck behind him. So now he knows, because he's gone out there to look. So what's he going to do? Is he going to set his brake, or is he going back?
I hope not. I got to get out here in the morning.
There you go, that way.
Okay. Yes, sir.
The door's over there anyway. Okay, there he goes. See, he knew how far he had to back up, and he's still looking at the shadow, because I'm looking at the shadow. And he's just about there.
Now, if that
were me... Unfortunately, he's not straight. He's in the parking spot at about a 20 degree angle, which is not only rude, it's lazy.
Yeah, but he's done for the night. I mean, he's done. That's it.
Yeah.
Play again.
Well, he is between the lines. Being between the lines is important.
That's critical. Absolutely critical.
And this particular parking lot is one of those that people dread due to the narrow parking spaces, poor lighting, and the fact that by this time of the evening, it's usually full.
We're in Cheyenne, Wyoming, flying J, I-25, exit 7, FYI.
To be avoided if you can.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, was one and only Uncle Michael, my personal mentor. He's taught me a lot, haven't you, Uncle Michael? Oh, it's all black. Nobody can see who you are. You're a man and a voice. Seriously, I can't see you on this.
No, that's fine. Nobody's missing anything by not seeing me.
I don't know. I think you're pretty sexy.
Well,
in a non-gay way, because I'm not gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Right. So that's how you back a truck into a space.
And as I said earlier, you're an odd one, Mr. Lynch.
Oh, now people know my last name.
Oh. Well, just don't publish that part.
I'll just edit that part out. All right.
Doofus.